LeRoy Butler in studio. Was there ever somebody on the in the doghouse like every like all the time when you were playing?
Well, it was Doug Evans, but mostly he was in the doghouse because he couldn't like come back from meetings on time because he was always on the phone. But if for you know a guy been in the doghouse, we had a guy named Rodney Artmore. Never forget this. This kid stayed in trouble with the coaches for whatever reason. He had decent talent, but we could never see it because he just rubbed the coaches the wrong way. Mm-hmm. You know, called the coaches by their first name.
I was going to say, was he too familiar? Because I could see where that could get irritating. Where you know,
what's
like,
up, Bob? How you doing today?
Ooh.
Yeah. Hey, Bob, your wife's dressed. I don't like polka dots. Maybe she's a stick to stripes. I mean.
Was he one of those people who like thinks he's being funny, but in fact, he's like really offensive?
And being dumb.
Yeah, right.
Like
yeah.
Family night, he has no family. So he just walks around from table to table eating people food. And, you know,
what was his name?
Rodney Artmore.
Artmore?
He was back when Ray Rose was your coach. But he was just a – he stayed in the doghouse. We really couldn't see how good the guy was because he just was a
– Okay, Rodney Artmore. Yeah. He's on Facebook if you want to look him up. He's Galveston, Texas, June 14, 1974. Played for the Green Bay Packers during the 99 season from Baylor University.
Yeah, I can see what you're saying. I don't like the way he looks. I can tell he's a bad seed just by looking at him.
I don't want to get into that. But.
I can tell by looking at him.
Carol's good that way.
But aren't most criminals, I'm not going, this is a different direction. Yeah, but aren't most criminals good-looking guys?
No.
They seem to get married quicker than free guys.
Dude, I've seen
they
Richard
get married all the time.
Well, that's because there's women out there that fall in love with these guys because they want to change them. That's the ultimate change.
But they're
change.
Never getting
no,
out.
No, women want to change men, and the ultimate way to change a man is to try to figure out, you know, who's the most notorious guy, and he's in prison. I'm going to marry him and change him.
Ooh. Right.
That's what they think.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh,
yeah. Women like edgy. Women like edgy. Oh. They're a little
women like fake edgy. We've talked about this with Ted Perry. Women want a guy who's got like a 4-day growth of beard to pull up on his Harley Davidson, jump off, and then
with no job,
and then bring on his brand new salmon recipe. Ted says and make it for you, you know, because that's fake edgy. That's now a guy like that who's in prison. That's like
that's edgy. That's you know he's crossed over the line, but women will still go for it.
Yeah, because they want to change him.
Right. Well, I disagree a little bit. I just I think that some women just like a guy that's going to keep them on their toes. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, like don't fall asleep at night. He might stab you. Is that what you're saying?
No.
Some of these criminals? Is that what you mean?
No.
I'm Keith Morrison.
What I'm saying is you never got their number down. You're always thinking. They always keep you thinking. You're not exactly sure what they're going
to
do.
Could I tell my daughters to date a specific guy. Now, I think more of my 12-year-old, she's never going to date guys. That's just me.
Yeah, that's what
But the 17, 18, and the 26-year-old, out of those three, only two listened to me. And that's the 17, 18-year-old. My 26-year-old, she didn't listen. She was the, you know, celebrity kid that wanted to be with a bad guy.
I'm telling
If he didn't have tattoos and goals and goals in his mouth and all that, I mean, if he didn't look like rough and like he was, you know,
looked
the part,
right?
She didn't like him,
right?
It was a guy, he had a good job.
She just wanted to shock you, didn't she?
She wanted
you to like react whenever she brought him home.
Well, after a while, you couldn't bring him.
Mm-hmm.
No, remember the story I told you about? She had took him back there and they tried on my Super Bowl ring.
Yeah, I do remember that story.
She
came
in with him.
Yeah.
They go over there, they try on the Super Bowl ring, and I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on? First of all, it's a perimeter.
Mm-hmm.
No one come past the living room part.
Mm-hmm.
No, do you take him back there? You got him trying on my ring. Just thing you know, next thing you know, he's on your bank account. Next thing you know, $1,000 is missing out of your bank. First of all, I didn't know you had $1,000. He takes money out of your account. Dad, he stole money. Great. Let's call the police. Wait. Before we call the police, how did he get the money? Oh, I took him down there, and I put him on the account, and, he didn't take it, Dennis. He's on the account.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you just got had because you won't listen.
Mm-hmm. At some point in time, we'll just have to have a big girl talk.
Well,
maybe
you can
just
talk,
open the lines, and the women can try and, you know, reveal to you.
You can talk to the two middle ones that's going to college.
Me?
The oldest one, I don't know if you want to deal with her.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you may just say, Butler, I give up.
I mean, just, hey. Come over here. Straighten up. Fly right. Let's go.
Can you smack her? I won't even.
I'm not getting your daughter.
No.
No, you. I'm giving you outside of
religion. No, no. Beat her. No. No, that's going to get her in trouble.
I mean, if you haven't been arrested.
We'll call Rodney Artmore and see what he's doing. We'll call Rodney Artmore.
Yeah, that's a perfect date for her.
Yeah.
Listen, you're so
disgusting.
She can
get Packer tickets now. She's such a weirdo. Oh, that girl's crazy.